So let's really quickly, because it's late and I'm tired, and it's another midweek event, run through my predictions for the UFN. I need to add that I'm going to do one recap video for these three recent MMA events, the two midweek UFNs and the UFC in the middle, afterwards, hopefully before the end of this week. let's start then. Glover Teixeira is fighting Ryan Bader on the main event. Glover has 12... I'm going out of my head. He's got 12 TKO victories, but he also wins by submission. He's on a 19 fight win streak. I did actually count all 19 of them. Ryan tends to lose by submission, and his record's far from brilliant. Loss, win, win, loss, win. Do you know, I actually think that Glover might win here, and he might win by submission. Well, at least that's what I've written down here. Bar submission in a second. Francisco Trinaldo is fighting Purity Holman, or something like that. And I'm going for a Francisco decision victory. Rafael Natal is fighting Tor Troeng. Now, although Rafael tends to win by submission, I'm going to give Tor the benefit of the doubt here and go for a decision victory there. Marcos Vinicius. Now, what we're discovering is that the UFC, particularly with Brazilians on Brazilian cards, tend to not use their full names. This is really because their full names are usually an entire sentence. So what you generally tend to find is that they will give one name plus the nickname. Now, if you don't know that, it can be quite difficult, because just writing in Marcos Vinicius, for example, into Sherdog will give you about 10 different Marcos Vinicius something, 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 something. And you have to choose which you think is the right one. So, in one way, it's probably to reduce the amount of words. But in another way, it's sort of a little bit unprofessional, because should they not actually write out the full name? Particularly when there are some people who are not so used to the UFC and who may not know exactly who these people are. He is fighting Ali Bagotinov. And I think that he will make history here. I think he will finish with a bar submission in the third. He will then be the first to beat this Bagotinov by submission. Lucas Martins is fighting Junior Hernandez. And I am going for Junior Hernandez by decision. I have a funny feeling, although I could be wrong there, that Junior Hernandez is the MFS fighter. I could be wrong there, but I think so. And Joe Zeffirino is fighting Elias Silverio. And I'm going for a choke sub in the first for Zeffirino there. Now, the understudy for the main event is what I think will be fight of the night. And this is Yushin Okami versus Ronaldo Souza. Ronaldo Souza is absolutely excellent on the ground. And Yushin Okami tends to want to stand. I don't like Yushin Okami, and I don't really know why. But I have a feeling that if Ronaldo Souza can get this to the ground at all, he'll win. So I'm going to go for a choke submission in the third round, because I'll give Yushin Okami the benefit of the doubt there. Joseph Benavidez is fighting Josiah Formiga. Joseph Benavidez, very, very big in WEC, if you remember. I've decided to go for him by decision. The next fight also looks quite interesting. This is Felipe Arantes fighting Kevin Souza. Now, both of these fighters are strikers. And Kevin Souza, he's got 12 out of 13 of his victories in that manner. Although Felipe Arantes also wins on the ground, I don't feel he's got enough there to make it striker versus groundsman. So I think he will be striking as well, and unfortunately I think that will be his downfall. So I'm going to go for a TKO in the first, in fact, there for Kevin Souza. Keith Wisniewski is fighting Ivan George. Keith has a record of 28 and 14. Not a brilliant record, that. He's also on a 2-loss streak, which isn't brilliant. He does win by submission, which is unfortunate for him, because Ivan George is very, very good at submission. In fact, he's on a 6-fight win streak, and 5 of those are RNC victories. The other one is also a choke of some kind, I believe. His record much, much, much better, 24-3. Now, I'm going to give Keith the benefit of the doubt, and this could be the underdog of the night. I don't really know what people think about these two, so I don't know if he's an underdog or not, but I wouldn't be surprised. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and go for a decision victory there. The last match on the card is Yuri Villafort fighting Sean Spencer. Now, Yuri Villafort is actually coming off 2 losses in a row. But I am going to give him the decision victory. Now, I do feel that Villafort is good at submissions. And I do also recognise that his opponent has a weakness for being caught in submissions. But with a 2-loss streak, I think it's better to just sort of say, make a more conservative guess at what's going to happen. So I'm going to go for a decision victory there. The roundup follows in the end credits, and as I said before, there will be a recap for all three with how I've done on predictions, because I know that I have slipped up with sort of making the predictions videos for these and getting them distributed. It's been a horrible mess. I do apologise. But I will be able to straighten that out, hopefully, after Wednesday and before the weekend. Terima kasih.